And new at 10 tonight, take a look at these. Have you ever seen anything like these? Probably not. Well, these are creative bike lane barriers designed to keep riders safe and clean blighted streets. Our WREG's Andrew Ellison is live in Binghamton tonight. And Andrew, can you tell us about these barriers and why they're so special?
Yeah, Stephanie, you know, if you look closely at them, you can probably tell they're made from old tires. So the idea behind this program is simple. Take something that's been dumped and turn it into something useful.
The Binghamton Development Corporation is nailing down safety while cleaning blighted streets and giving jobs to people who sorely need them.
It's been pretty good.
A program where crews take tires dumped in the community and turn them into creative bike lane barriers designed by local artist Tad Pearson.
I think it's a creative use to solve a practical problem. I have a history of creating art pieces out of tires, made some trash cans, tire chairs, so it was not a great leap for me.
Workers use this machine to slice the tires into strips before painting and installing them on the road.
We got a great crew.
The BDC giving many of these jobs to people who have criminal records or have struggled with drug and alcohol addiction.
You got to look at it in the light of, if we don't, then who will? You know, everybody deserves a second chance, or sometimes, in some cases, a third chance.
Charles Wesley fought addiction for years.
I had nowhere to go. I was going to be homeless.
But that all changed when the BDC hired him 3 months ago.
Now, I pay my own rent. I got my driver's license last Friday. I have a Fort Truck certification. I'm OSHA 30 certified. This program just keeps giving and giving.
This pilot program, approved by the city, is funded by several grants. Right now, the barriers are only going on Broad Avenue, but the BDC hopes to expand.
Just kind of getting things on the right track.
Who knows where we can go with it?
Yeah, crews expect to use more than 400 dumped tires for this pilot program, and Pearson says he has more designs he wants to use if the project expands. Live in Binghamton, Andrew Ellison, WREG News, Channel 3.
So far, it sounds like a win-win. Thanks, Andrew.